Hi everyone, Scorp here, continuing the Duels of the Roses Redux mod playthrough. Today we're continuing Fairies slash Light. Go ahead and go to Joey, I think. We should be well past strong enough to take down Joey. Cards we want basically entirely consist of Goblin Secret Remedy. The Toon Terrain's pretty nice for us since we have two Gwakatano Megamis now. And we drew Hourglass of Courage. That's good. Only problem is that her hand sucks. Besides that, just pass. Now this is a person that will actually pursue you. And he just played a really strong creature turn one. So I can't get away with the really easy wins that I usually do. This can never get below 1300, so it's fine. We just fuse out a second Thousand Dragon? An open double Time Wizard? Wow. Yeah, and he fused off a Manga Ryuran to do it too. Let's see here. We'll get rid of this and this. I'm not getting rid of Genin because I might need it to fuse with the Dancing Elf. Probably won't, but I might end up needing to. It would probably have been better to have played that closer to the Toon Terrain. Looks like we're fusing this. Figure out grab the Grave Robber, and then I'm going to use Hourglass of Courage to bait the Thousand Dragon. And we basically are just going to start a counterattack here. Yeah, this should be pretty easy. Easy win at this point. He can no longer get over my cards, so game over. Rain Temperature being 3000 attack is already enough to pretty much win the duel, because the strongest creature is Thousand Dragon. I could have played Flash and Ingen first, but it's not really gonna matter. So there's no monster in his deck that he can actually beat this with. This is 3100 on Toon Terrain, so absolutely nothing he can do about it anymore. That ties the defense of Manga Ryuran on Toon, so he's just dead. I would like to give him a turn to try to play Goblin Secret Remedy. I'll go this way. I don't need Eye of Truth. Just play a Hashiningen. I am very surprised that he just didn't move. I would really like a Goblin Secret Remedy, so I'm gonna actually keep killing stuff. Just show off that I... I'm gonna actually equip this. I don't want to move it. Sir, you really should move backwards. We'll fuse on top of this. If this doesn't back him up, I don't know what will. I don't have a card to play behind me, so I do kind of have to just kill him. I really did want a Goblin Secret Remedy. Oh, he has an Acid Trap Hole behind him. That's why he wasn't moving. Or maybe it's an invisible wire. Yeah, leader abilities are good. I don't really care for anything, so let's just go for 3 in a row. Let's go with the right slot first. And I missed. Baby Dragon's not terrible. I'd like to have gotten a card that's like 15 deck costs to reincarnate. Let's go... Dual Mako an extra time. I would like to get a Tears of the Mermaid from him. And our light deck is super strong against waters. I mean, I guess I do have red medicine for Shoddy, but I don't like just red medicine. If you can't tell, I'm setting up to use a Gwakatana Megami. On Happy Lovers, so let's go ahead and get rid of some cards that I don't want. We should be able to play another Happy Lover next turn. Oh, that's a trap. Value. Absolute value. Unfortunately, I didn't need that much value. I just need to get rid of the Hashinengen to do more buffing. We will start bringing cards together to go on this offensive. I'm gonna probably Bright Castle one of these Happy Lovers, and then at that point there's nothing more he can do. $3,400 is pretty strong. Well, that's a trap. I don't need monsters very much right now, so I will get to the Heavy Storm. Really, the thing that I'd like the most is just another... one more buff on my creatures. Seems like a pretty bad use of Umi. And I drew a buff, so perfect. Okay, I'm in a Heavy Storm. I don't need to because of my leader power, but unless those were three shadow spells, those were cards that I wanted. Nope, two Tears of a Mermaid. Pretty perfect. $3,500 outside of his leader range is absolutely impossible for him to beat. Even inside of his leader range, it's basically impossible for him to beat it. And there goes the Crab Turtle, so... $3,450 inside his leader range, so... if you can get to a 3,500 Happy Lover, you just win. As I said, this duel's over. It's just a matter of time. And that's game over. Now we just have to get some Tears of the Mermaid. We got tiers and we got a three in a row. Good enough. And let's go back and duel Joey one more time to try to get another goblin or a goblin secret remedy. Be much nicer. I just don't enjoy dealing with Shoddy when one of my main buff cards is Hourglass of Courage. Fighting him with 3,000 life points is not fun. Even with red medicine, it's only 3,500. Magical Labyrinth's probably actively bad in this situation. I believe Dark Witch is stronger than anything he could have played first turn, so I can get rid of that. Probably not worth the get rid of the Gen in there because it cost me a star point. I am really hoping to draw Gwikotana Megami next turn, so I'm going to try to increase my odds at it ever so slightly. It would be nice to draw the two and whatever. Well, I drew it. So we'll just get rid of that. Moon Envoy is probably not going to be very useful, unless I climb up with a dancing elf, but my chances of actually doing that are always pretty slim, because I only have one. I don't need life in this matchup. I've already created strong enough creatures. Life is really good in matchups where I'm not playing against, or I'm playing against somebody with really strong cards. This isn't exactly that kind of matchup. That's way too small. It's one of the cards that I'm kind of looking for. Looking for that kind of card. Let's discard Skill and go to... Thank you. I would like to give him a turn, just to see if he'll actually play a Goblin Secret Remedy. It's honestly a little terrifying that he won't move in this situation. What was your trap, sir? Ooh, a mesmeric control. I can take one of those. That was a little dangerous, but as long as I don't get hit by an invisible wire, I'm fine. We can face up defense this. New Atori wouldn't be a terrible card to get from him. Oh hey, he finally moved. I will let him move that new Atori to defense mode. Because, if he doesn't, he's dead. Oh, we are very much in the driver's seat this game. We have done all of the buffing, and he has not played a single Goblet Secret Remedy. He has played a Muyan Curry and a Mesmeric Control. A little terrifying to play against, to be honest. I'm sure Joey's not having the greatest time here. Let's see what Heavy Storm gets rid of. Probably nothing. Oh, one of the cards. This there, this there, this here, and that there. Well, he didn't play it. Didn't play it in the first half of his deck. Can't really be that mad about it. Guess we'll just have to move on to Shoddy without it. Let's go for the Mooyan curry. And a mesmeric control. I don't really want the Mooyan curry, but you might as well grab it. Try for the Nuatori. Good, get it. Nuatori is nice because it doubles healing. Which is sometimes extremely useful. Go ahead and do a reincarnation, and then we'll come back and do Shoddy. I'd like to reincarnate something that is low deck cost. I'm thinking block attack, so I'll be right back. Well, this was a really fortunate reincarnation that I found, so we'll definitely take it. We got an extra dancing elf, which is extremely good. And we also got ourselves a bright castle, which is also exceedingly good. Shining Friendship is continuing to be just a brick in my deck, so I'll get rid of it. I also don't really like Eye of Truth. It's generally just been a wasted card slot. I have too many cards that cost too much, so I'm going to take out an Aranite Parshath. Cost too much summoning power. I should specify. And then, yeah, this should be a pretty decent setup for this deck. Now let's try to get through Shoddy relatively quickly. Honestly, it's surprising how low his deck cost is, considering he has just desserts in it. And that one card is almost a tenth of his deck cost. Gate Deeg wouldn't be terrible for this deck. I do have to be kind of aggressive on him. Even though this deck does not do aggression very well. Orion is just strictly worse than Dark Witch, so I'm just gonna get rid of it. Move Mesmeric Control over here to get the creature that got buffed. We don't need life. Rayon Temperature would be a good card to start buffing. Okay, we're gonna lay that there. He buffed a Wings of Wicked Flame. Terrifying. Ooh, Molten Behemoth's not good for me to deal with. We'll try to do these things behind my deck leader. Kill that next turn. I don't want to go much past 5 cards on my field ever, so that I don't get just burned out by Just Desserts really bad. Is there ever a world he attacks me here? There is! I believe this is a world that he loses. I'm not gonna get Deke this way. But this guy's annoying, so getting rid of him is really good. It's a pretty decent beat stick that I made relatively quickly. And it was a nice quick duel, so that's good. Hey, we got something. Ew. Not something good, but we got something. With that, we have made it to Jasper Dice Tutor. Gone through most people so far pretty easily. He's going to give us Darkness Approaches, which is going to make our deck a whole lot stronger. And then we can just finish out the playthrough. So, thanks everybody for watching, and have a nice day.